Please rise. Third District Court is now in session. The Honorable Richard Carrazzo presiding.
Have a seat, please. One moment, please. All right. We're on the record 231500139, State of Utah versus Kouri Richins. Can I have counsel for the state make their appearance, please?
Patricia Cassell.
Brad Levin.
And for the defense?
Sky Lazaro.
Very good. Good afternoon, Ms. Richins. All right, we're here for a scheduling conference. Ms. Lazaro, tell me where we are.
The state and I have been working through discovery and some requests that I've made. We've come to an agreement on everything. There might be one issue we bring to your attention in the future, but we're not there yet. So there's some things we're still working on getting turned over. We filed a stipulated motion for a protective order with a proposed order, I think, right before this hearing that we finalized. With regard to some personnel and some law enforcement records that I've requested. So I think there's still some discovery coming, but I feel like we are working, both of us, really hard. The state's been really diligent about getting things to us as quickly as possible and organizing it. I will say that there is a copious amount of records. I think our base numbers are up over 1.2 million at this point. A lot of it is phone downloads. So that's status wise as far as what's happening. That's kind of where we're at.
All right. Where do you want to go from here?
I would be okay to set a prelim because I don't anticipate any discovery issues as of right now coming up. I think we'll have everything. I do think that it's going to take some time for us to digest everything and have our investigator follow up on what we need to do in order to be prepared for the preliminary hearing.
Talk to me about how you see the preliminary hearing being substantively different than the evidence presented at the detention.
I think with regard to, I would have to let the state speak to who they're going to call. I don't necessarily see several of the counts being much different. I don't know if they'll call a medical examiner or things along that line, or just the detective, or 1102 statements. That's going to be up, I guess, to them to decide how they want to present the information. I do expect it to be different in regards to the financial count allegations with regard to what they're going to have to present as evidence in order to meet their burden with regard to the elements of each of those. So I do expect a lot more on that side of things than what we heard at the detention hearing.
Okay.
Well, like I said, that's up to them too, so.
Ms. Cassell?
I think that's fair. We have not amended the information, but we anticipate that we will.
And is that the reference to the financial crimes?
Yes, that is the reference to the financial crimes. Okay. And so, and then we will, that will be in addition to what I believe, and we haven't made that determination yet either, but that'll be in addition to what we, the witnesses we called or evidence we provided at the detention hearing.
All right. Do you have a sense of when you're filing amended information?
We met yesterday with the Attorney General's office. I think we got some good information out of that. I think we could be prepared to file soon.
Forgive me, I didn't follow that reference.
Oh, they're just helping us understand.
Okay.
the insurance fraud.
I see.
And helping with investigation.
Okay. So I cut you off there, right?
No, I'm just saying, I think that we would be in a position to file within the next couple weeks.
Okay, assuming you do that, are you prepared to set a preliminary hearing?
I think we're prepared to set a preliminary hearing. I think it would kind of determine. I think, I guess it depends on how far out you are willing to set it, but yeah, I think we're prepared to set a preliminary hearing.
Well, I'll set it as earlier or as late, I guess, with reluctance as defendant wants. But it sounds like the state's prepared to go forward whenever I set one.
Well, yeah, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Realistically, they've had 18 months to prepare their case, and
right.
I'm just getting all the discovery. So, you know, bearing that in mind, realistically, I don't think there's any way we can be prepared for a prelim just with the amount of documents and information that we need to get through until after the first of the year. And I'm thinking more like February or March. And I hate to do that to my client because she's
in custody. We are just showing probable cause, right?
Well, I understand that, Judge, but I have to read the thing. I mean, I can't.
I'm not suggesting otherwise.
I mean, I understand the burden and I understand the state's burden, but if I don't, I'm gonna be ineffective from the word go if I don't read what they provided to me.
Okay. Well, do you want to set that today or do you want another schedule?
I'm happy to do it however the court feels most comfortable. I guess it doesn't matter that much to me if we're setting it out a ways or if we want to come back maybe in November or beginning of December for a status and see where we're at on everything, and if we're in a good place then get one set.
I think our only concern was, Judge, of getting on your calendar. So if we set it out for another scheduling in say 30 to 60 days.
It may not surprise you that this case will just push its way in my calendar.
Fair enough.
In large part because Richins is in custody, right? Any in custody case of this magnitude would push things out of the way, so that won't be a problem.
I would anticipate several days for a prelim. And I'm just thinking on the financial crimes.
Hard for me to understand.
Right.
Way. Not that I need to evaluate it, but I don't know what those counts are.
I don't either.
Yeah.
So.
All right. I'm comfortable setting this in November for a status conference. I respect the amount, the volume of information that you need to review. I think it bears repeating, right, that under the Utah Constitution and cases interpreting it, the preliminary hearing is not a discovery tool, and so the state gets to choose what they want to put on for probable cause, and we'll judge it according to the showing.
I don't intend to use it as a discovery tool. I think the requests I've made for discovery are comprehensive, and
okay.
The state, we haven't had any discovery problems. I mean, I don't anticipate using it for that. But having done a number of white collar and financial crimes cases, I also understand, you know, what goes into those counts and what I'm gonna need to do. And you're right, the state does get to choose who they call and they don't necessarily have to tell me what that's going to be ahead of time. So if I don't have an understanding of the case, I'm not gonna be able to effectively cross-examine anyone either.
All right, let's see. This felt like it worked in terms of doing it at 1:30 p.m. on a Friday afternoon. Is that acceptable?
That's great with me.
Is it so?
Yes, that's fine.
Yeah. How about November 3, 1:30 p.m. in person?
Yeah, that works for me.
Works for us.
Okay. Ms. Richins, your next court date, unless Ms. Lazaro requests an earlier one, which I'm happy to provide, is November 3, 1:30 p.m. in person. We'll see you back then.
Thank you.
All right. Very good, counsel. Thank you.
Thank you.
Court's in recess.
All right.
Yeah, you are here. Yeah, we have a couple of witnesses. No. We haven't even called the case.
We'll let you come back. Yeah, stop that.
Just for really fast.
That's fine. I'll put her in there. I just associate notes. I put the other guy in.